There were no second-year ICOM students on campus Monday after several tested positive for COVID-19 in the last few days. However, the work of healthcare professionals can't stop, even in the middle of a pandemic. Medical reporter Jessica Taylor walks us through how the school is keeping operations going.
An interesting semester for medical students.
And it's impossible to teach people to learn how to be a physician completely online. There has to be in-person training, and I don't think anybody would want their physician to come out of medical school having not worked with actual people.
ICOM itself has kept doors open for students thanks to extensive cleaning and safety procedures.
As soon as we get notification that a student may have called in feeling ill, we begin contact tracing even before they test positive.
When students test positive for COVID, the building shuts down for 3 days.
And since July, that's happened 3 times. It did happen to us again last week. When that happens, it's, it's disruptive, but we clean the facility, we bring people back, and we move on.
Students try and mitigate the risk by gearing up in PPE alongside physicians when working in hospitals for their hands-on work. ICOM students serve 10 different locations.
We have had we've had one or two institutions that have put a pause on medical students and training. It's only affected a handful of our students, but it is concerning as the numbers of cases go up in our region around the country that more hospitals may decide that they don't want to have medical students.
Which happened last winter.
And it could happen again as the spike gets worse.
The medical school also has a COVID-19 task force that relays information to their community. Jessica Taylor, Idaho News 6.
And the second-year students, which is the class that accounts for all the current positive cases, will be able to go back on campus today.